Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. I'm Eric Edberg. Welcome to my living room, and thank you for having us into yours. We're going to have a great Thanksgiving Eve show tonight with a wide variety of music, an original poem from Joe Heithouse, who lives here in Greencastle, Indiana, and 32 ballerinas from all over the world dancing to the music of Camille Saint-Saëns, The Swan, as performed by my friend Wade Davis in Baltimore. Our Greencastle Virtual Music Festival programs are becoming rapidly national and international programs. We started again this week. It was what I think may become our theme music, No Particular Place to Go by Chuck Berry, is covered by the highly inventive Avery Waite of Sedona, Arizona. I just love that video and the energy that it brings. So I wanted to start with that again. In addition to lots of music and poetry, friends and neighbors are going to be sharing what we are grateful for this Thanksgiving, even in this coronavirus Thanksgiving. There's stuff to be grateful for. And speaking of that, here's Cullen Edberg, who has some relation to me, speaking from the home she shares with her husband in Mexico City and reporting on what a certain group of people tell her they are grateful for this Thanksgiving.
From a general Facebook poll and one-on-one interviews, children of the world, what are you thankful for this year? Dear Mom and Dad, I am thankful for food. Thank you for my house and my toys and my school. I am grateful for fruit. Love, Connor. Mom, I love when you make baked mac and cheese. The stuff on top is so good. Dad, thank you for teaching me a lot of stuff about politics and math and investments. It makes me a smarter person. I am thankful for my sister and my whole family and my shoes so I don't have to walk in the dirt. Love, Milan. Mom, we are thankful when you make chicken curry. It is so good. We wish we could eat an entire pot. We love playing with you after dinner. Dad, we are thankful when you grill. We are thankful when you put batteries in our remote control cars and let us play with the underwater camera. We like when you tell us stories at night. Love, Isaac and Orson. And from a general Facebook inquiry as reported by parents, what are you thankful for? Computer and internet, family, parents, and phones. That we are home lounging more as a family and not always rushing to get somewhere. Joe Biden and Kamala Harris, our dog, the tire swing, God, and Spider-Man. Happy Thanksgiving.
Here's just a little tiny piece of writing by Aldo Leopold, who wrote this famous book, A Sand County Almanac. It describes November. If I were the wind that makes music in November corn is in a hurry. The stalks hum, the loose husks whisk skyward in half playful swirls, and the wind hurries on. In the marsh, long windy waves surge across the grassy sloughs, beat against the far willows. A tree tries to argue, bare limbs waving, but there is no detaining the wind. On the sandbar, there is only wind, and the river sliding seaward. Every wisp of grass is drawing circles on the sand. I wander over the bar to a driftwood log, where I sit and listen to the universal roar and to the tinkle of wavelets on the shore. I just think that's important.
Thank you. So we just heard our good friend Joe Heidhouse reading a short poem, and Joe will be back later with a longer poem that he wrote just for tonight, and it is really cool. He was followed by Minghui Kuo, who is the wonderful percussion professor at DePauw University's School of Music here in Greencastle, Indiana. She was performing in Goeben Church, where we hold the concerts for the Summer Music Festival when we're able to have in-person concerts, and where Brian Langdock, the pastor of Goeben, is filming many of our virtual performances. And now here are three members of Goeben. Carol Craig, who is the new president of our board of directors for the Summer Music Festival, her husband Eric, and then Beth Newton Watson, who is one of the chaplains at DePauw, tells what they're grateful for, followed by May Pong, who's just an extraordinary pianist on the faculty of the School of Music also, and she's playing Percy Grainger's just amazing Fantasia on Bach's Sheep May Safely Graze. So be grateful, enjoy, and I'll see you after May finishes playing for us.
Hi, happy Thanksgiving to everyone. This Thanksgiving, I really am thankful for all the music donors for Greencastle Summer Music Program and also the music donors within all of Greencastle that may bring all the concerts to us, but especially our donors for the Greencastle Summer Music Program. Thank you and have a blessed Thanksgiving.
I would like to thank Eric Edberg and the Summer Music Festival and all the participants for all the years of wonderful music and for this virtual music that we are having now. Happy Thanksgiving, one and all.
Hello, my name is Beth Newton Watson, and this Thanksgiving, I am thankful that there is green outside my window and a fire in my fireplace, and a chance to spend some time thanking the people who have made this year so much easier for us all. I'm glad for the chance to cook food that we love and for the fact that people are keeping a careful distance to make sure we're all healthy. So, happy Thanksgiving, everybody.
Thank you.
Well, we're just so fortunate here in Putnam County to have people like Eric and Carol and Beth, and to have artists like Ming and May, and upcoming soon is going to be Bobby Lancaster and Veronica Pedro, and we're going to have Sandy Williams and Jesse Whitman. So, wow, what an evening it is. Now, speaking of gratitude, people have written me as to what they're grateful for. So here's what they have to say. I'm Allison. I think this Allison is the one that I used to be married to. I'm Allison, and I'm grateful for my teachers who communicated their love for music and for me in every lesson. I'm Christina, and I'm grateful for local organizers in my community who identify need and make it easy for those of us with extra to put it directly where it can help. I'm Cindy, and I'm grateful to Eric for putting all these online concerts together to bring a bit of happiness and relaxation to people during this stressful season. And you're welcome. It's my privilege to do that. I'm Rita, and I'm grateful for all the essential workers that continue to fight for people's lives during the COVID-19 pandemic. I'm Tim, and I'm grateful for everyone who is part of the Green Castle Music Festival. I'm Linda, and I am grateful for a community which supports creative people and arts of all kinds. And I love that we're, you know, including photography, we have dance this week, yeah, celebrating all the arts, so important. I'm Mary Williams Druyar, and I don't know if that's how you pronounce your name, so my apologies if I mispronounced it. And I'm grateful for my Greencastle childhood. I didn't get to have a Greencastle childhood, but my kids did. I am Leslie, and every day I'm grateful for J.S. Bach, my students, and all the amazing musicians I have met in my travels. Wow. So, here is artist, photographer, and author, and the very first president of the Greencastle Summer Music Festival Board, Stu Fabe, followed by Joe Heithaus's new poem.
Hi, everyone. When Eric invited me to comment on what's meaningful to me during this Thanksgiving holiday, my natural inclination, of course, was to comment about family and friends and their health and well-being. But I also wanted to say that I'm enormously grateful for the pool of talent, not only in our community, but all around us that bring such a wonderful array of and diversity of song and musicianship and poetry and all sorts of different things that really make me aware of how special our fellow man is. So I wish all of you a very happy Thanksgiving and a wonderful holiday season, and look forward to more beautiful concerts that our great impresario Eric Edberg brings to our community. Thanks.
Here's a poem called Thanks 2020. On Greencastle Square, there's a memorial to the American doughboys of the First World War. A bronze statue of a soldier stands with his arm raised toward what was once Prevost's department store, but now is Starbucks. For years, I thought he was waving until one day I realized that he is throwing a grenade. Maybe that defines this year we thought at first was waving, but now has thrown us its grenades of pandemic and racial injustice, political upheaval with its signs and flags and distrust. And who will forget the great mask wars? Thanks, 2020. Thanks for making me such a reader of the news, for teaching me so much about how a virus works, for making my hands so clean and my surfaces hygienic. Thanks for giving me back my kids who we'd thought might never return to home. Thanks for keeping them here indefinitely. And for all the ways they've corrected me, I had no idea I have so many annoying habits. Thanks for giving me the chance to cook so many meals, to eat so many home-baked goodies. Thanks for so many disagreements. My marriage is now forged in fire. Thanks for cozying up with our whole family to watch Tiger King and Ozark, so we could be even more thankful for our petty little problems and our mundane lives. Thanks for driving me out of my house and teaching me to fish the Big Walnut Creek, to catch and release smallmouth bass with a rod called an ugly stick and a Z-Man mushroom jig. These were products I hadn't known or heard of. Thanks for letting me go outside to walk and jog at the nature park with what seemed at times every other resident of Greencastle. Thanks for allowing me to shelter in this place, this Indiana home, with its buzz bomb and heritage wall and painted grain elevators and memories of John Dillinger and Martin Luther King. And that doughboy I thought was waving to me, who seems to greet us when we pass, saying, "Hello, hello."
I just am so grateful for Joe for composing that poem. And he and I were talking after I recorded him doing that yesterday about how much it means to those of us who are creative and performing artists to have a chance to create during this time. And it really is a privilege for me to be hosting and putting together these virtual music festival things. I'm learning so much about video editing and really having a blast. It also takes about 20 times longer than I hoped it would or thought that it might. So that's been a learning too. Okay, you know, one of the real fixtures of Greencastle's musical life and spiritual life is Bobby Lancaster. And Bobby both has an original song for us and something to say about what she's grateful for.
Hi, friends. My name is Bobby Lancaster. I'm a singer-songwriter, thankful to make Greencastle my home. And during this crazy season, I think what I'm most thankful for is hope. Hope that one day this virus will end. Hope that we'll be able to gather again. And the hope that this life is only the beginning of my soul's journey and not the end. Happy Thanksgiving.
Put my hope in when that I'll see that city where there's no more crying and the light of love is always shining on that day when you call my name and you came.
Boy, we are so lucky to have artists like Bobby and her colleague Veronica Pedrell, who was playing the piano in that. Wow, wow. Just, you know, Greencastle is such a great place. And if you're watching this from somewhere else, when this coronavirus stuff is over and you can travel, come visit Putnam County, Indiana. It is a gorgeous place. You're within short drives of just zillions of covered bridges, and there's fantastic restaurants. And during the summer, there is the Greencastle Summer Music Festival, and when there's not stuff during the summer, there's tons of things happening at DePauw University and in local bars and restaurants in terms of music, at least when we're not having coronavirus. Okay, so next, Swans for Relief. This is just an extraordinary collaboration between the cellist Wade Davis, who lives in Baltimore and is a friend of mine, and 32 Prima ballerinas from all around the world, and they got together and created this video where everybody danced to Wade's performance that you're going to hear, what's become one of the most famous performances of Saint-Saëns' The Swan from the Carnival of the Animals ever. And this is a project where they are raising money for out-of-work dancers. You know, the whole performing arts industry collapsed, shut down last March all over the world. And to date, as of today, $290,566 have been raised to assist dancers who are out of work. And it would be great if you would go to the URL that you'll see on the screen and at the end and in the description on YouTube and Facebook, etc. See if we can kick that up to $291,000. That would be just really terrific. Anyway, Wade and I talked for about 20 minutes yesterday, and here is a short excerpt from that with him talking about the process of putting this together. And, you know, the joy he takes in this collaboration is so evident in this. I wanted to share it with you. And then we'll see the video that was the fruit of Wade and everybody else's labors. It's about 6 minutes long, and it's just a treat.
But all that's to say is, you know, sat down literally with a Bluetooth speaker, just played it loud enough so I could hear it, you know, and then played it. I thought, okay, that's pretty good. I played another one, and then I just sat with them for like, you know, a day. And then the next day I woke up and I listened to them both and I said, you know what, that first one is really beautiful. I said, that first one is really, really beautiful. Just I hear something in that first one. And I thought, okay, let me send it to Joseph. And that's when Joseph sent it to Misty. And that's when Misty sent me a few messages. And I was just like over the moon because, you know, I mean, Misty Copeland is this, you know, American prima donna, you know, who's really doing a lot for, you know, Black culture and just, you know, ballet in general, just with her sort of platform. And so, you know, when she was writing to me and telling me, you know, how enamored she was with my playing, I just thought, okay, I think I've done something big here. I think I'm done something big. So I had to sit on it for about a month, right? Because basically all the while I was getting messages from Misty with all the dancers that were going to be involved and, you know, just letting me know that, you know, this person has officially downloaded my, you know, Dropbox track. And so basically all the dancers that you'll see in the video, they recorded to my recording. Like they did not, you know, listen to somebody else and then like, you know, Joseph overdone it to me. They all recorded their segment and rehearsed to my playing, which still just gets me choked up in a way just to think like some of the most beautiful dancers in the world that I admire are dancing like that to my playing. And letting me know that my playing moved them to dance in that manner. I mean, there's nothing better than that for me.
Thank you.
Wasn't that something? You know, even in the worst of times, human creativity can lead to some marvelous things that, you know, might not have happened otherwise. So, as I've been asking a lot of people, I asked Wade, what are you thankful for this Thanksgiving?
I'm grateful to be alive. I'm grateful for Mr. Gibbs, who is my little baby dog, who helps me so much. I'm grateful for all these opportunities that I've had, you know, even in the midst of a pandemic. I'm grateful for, you know, these, you know, connections that I've had, people who are reaching out to me and, you know, wanting me to, you know, speak on panels or just checking in saying, you know, hey, Wade, what's up? How are you doing? You know, those things mean a lot. And that's really what I'm thankful for. Just real connections right now.
That's great. To me.
Thanks, Wade. So there's more music to come. But before that, just want to say how grateful I am for the opportunity to connect with people on Wednesday nights at GVMF.live on Zoom and talk. As the coronavirus situation seems to be, or not seems to be, is escalating. And as our lockdown appears to be something that we're going to be more locked down, especially those of us who are over 60, staying connected with other people is just so important. Now, one of the great things that has come out of the coronavirus, if you can talk about great things coming out of it, is that people have created ways of connecting and ways of collaborating artistically that they wouldn't have done before. So something like the Swans for Relief, wow, that would not have happened without the coronavirus. And yeah, maybe we'd prefer to not have had to do that, but wow, look at what human beings can do. And as Sandy Williams is going to point out for us very shortly, one of the things a lot of us have discovered is Zoom. Now, real life, in person, being with each other beats being on Zoom. But Zoom beats nothing. And we have this opportunity to connect with each other, whether it's the Wednesday night GVMF.live concerts or with your friends and family on Zoom while we're isolated. Just remember, we are wired to be connected with each other, and talking to people on the phone, connecting with your friends and loved ones on Zoom or FaceTime or Skype or whatever, that can make a huge difference in your life. Man, I get to have times where I talk with my daughter in Mexico City and my son in Shanghai. And, you know, we're all together. We're going to watch a movie together this Thanksgiving weekend. So do things like that. Okay, coming up next week, Deep Roots, singer-songwriters of Putnam County on December 2nd. Join us for that. On December 9th, we're going to have Lessons and Carols, the, you know, this great Anglican tradition that has been done at DePauw many times and at St. Andrew's Episcopal Church. Alumni of the School of Music are putting together a virtual Lessons and Carols service. So we'll have that on December 9. On December 16, we're going to have holiday winter solstice music from around the world. I'm very excited about that. And then on Wednesday, December 23, we're going to have a virtual Christmas caroling and Christmas cookie sharing party. Now, how the heck do you share Christmas cookies virtually? Well, we won't get to taste them, but you can send me photos and recipes, and we'll make that available to each other. And we're going to have a pianist and a song leader, and you have the opportunity to sing Christmas carols together. So I think that's going to be really cool. All right, and on December 30, Kathy Malik is putting together a great program for looking ahead to the new year. And what happens in January, I don't know yet. Working 1 month in advance. All right, now to take us out, here is Greencastle's own, the wonderful jazz guitarist Sandy Williams. Lives in Indianapolis now, but grew up here in Greencastle. And his colleague, Jesse Whitman, who performed so many songs for us last week's concert. They're performing Vernon Duke's Autumn in New York. And I got to say, I love New York. I love Autumn in New York. But this autumn, man, I am really glad to be here with you in Greencastle, Indiana. Enjoy, and I'll see you after the show at gvmf.live, and if not, then next week.
Hi, I'm Sandy Williams, and what I'm grateful for this Thanksgiving is to spend some time with my wife, Pam, and also for Zoom, because that allows us to celebrate Thanksgiving with our sons who are on either end of the country. Thank you.